Thank you, Foreign Secretary, Your Excellency, Prime Minister David Cameron, who is temporarily absent, Excellencies, Heads of State and Government, Excellencies Ban Ki-moon, Secretary General of the UN, Jiang Ping, Chairperson of the AU Commission, distinguished participants, ladies and gentlemen, I wish to express my profound appreciation to the Prime Minister and his colleagues in Her Majesty's Government for taking the initiative to organize this timely conference and for welcoming us to their great country. This is the one conference on Somalia that I have attended that appears to be condemned to succeed and to become a real turning point in the recent history of Somalia. Three events that have happened on the eve of the conference and which I suspect may have been influenced by the preparations of the conference assure me that this is indeed the case. Following the successful Garowe First Conference, Somali political leaders have in the past few days held the second Garowe Conference and come up with a clear roadmap for the post-August transition. This roadmap constitutes a solid basis for the international community to engage and assist Somalis as they chart a new course for their country. Garowe 2 is a major success because it's a Somali-owned process to chart a new course for their country. It's a major success also because it allows all stakeholders in the Somali peace process the basis for constructive engagement. The Somali crisis is first and foremost a political crisis, and it can only be resolved by political means through the reconstitution and renewal of the Somali state. We now have a credible and adequate roadmap charted by the Somalis themselves, which can lead to such a political solution. I am confident that this conference will be able to build on Garowe 2 and become the turning point in recent Somali history that it has had the potential of becoming from the very day it was initiated. Just yesterday, the Security Council has passed a resolution based on the strategic concept paper developed jointly by the African Union and the United Nations. We are grateful to the Prime Minister, Foreign Secretary, the United Kingdom for leading the charge on this important matter, and our other friends in the Security Council who approved your draft unanimously. This resolution will, among other things, increase the size and overall capacity of AMISOM. Beyond and above that, the resolution also confirms that the international community is united in its determination to fight terrorism and mayhem in Somalia and to provide Somalis with the comprehensive support they need to turn around the fate of their country. I am sure this conference will reinforce that unity and determination of the international community and make it possible for Somalis to succeed in their quest for peace and stability. Yesterday, TFG and Ethiopian troops defeated Al-Shabaab based in the Bay and Bokor region and liberated Baidoa, a major source of manpower and finance for them. Perhaps more importantly, Somalis all along the line of march of our troops came in droves to inform our troops where Al-Shabaab IEDs were planted, where Al-Shabaab was preparing an ambush, and finally, the residents of Baidoa braved the risk of Al-Shabaab retaliation to come out in their thousands and tens of thousands to welcome their liberators. This is one more proof, if proof is needed, that the Somali people have had enough of the terrorists and are prepared to do whatever it takes to defeat them. This is a clear indication of the rapidly improving capability of the TFG forces to fight and defeat Al-Shabaab. Coming as it does after the heroic battles that AMISOM has fought in and around Mogadishu, and similar battles that Kenyan and Ethiopian forces have fought to
together with TFG forces in other parts of Somalia. It shows that Africa and countries in the region are prepared to pay the ultimate sacrifice to support Somalis and to defeat Al-Shabaab. I'm convinced that this augurs well for the success of this conference. Your Excellency, distinguished participants, this is a very well-prepared conference that's taking place at a time significant changes for the better are happening in Somalia. We have to thank you, your very able officials and diplomats for preparing the excellent papers of the conference through extensive consultations with all stakeholders. My officials tell me that with a bit of creative ambiguity, a large measure of consensus has been achieved on all the key issues even before the conference started. I have no reason to doubt their judgment. However, on one crucial issue, that of how we deal with the terrorists, I hope the accent of the papers prepared for us is on the creative rather than the ambiguous. Al-Shabaab is a terrorist organization espousing an extreme interpretation of a great religion that is inimical to peace and stability in Somalia and the wider region. That ideology of violence and mayhem can and must be defeated. There is no room for compromise with the hardcore of Al-Shabaab and the things that they stand for. Assisting Al-Shabaab in any shape or form is not only in conflict with many UN Security Council resolutions and hence with international law, but also constitutes a crime against the well-being of the peoples of our region. I hope the consensus achieved by this conference does not in any way undermine these key principles. I thank you.